on Friday, Saturday night, Doomcock had Cameron Pasha on, or no, EBN had Cameron Pasha on, and Robert Mayer Burnett talking about Star Wars rumors and what's happening right now. And Robert Mayer Burnett really defended Kathy Kennedy without really acknowledging her crimes. Here we have a picture of unsold books at Target done by the Story Group under her supervision. Here's Claudia Gray's novel, Into the Darkness, and here's Claudia, sexually obsessed, poor writer, here's a character she created, an asexual gay guy, and an ambulatory rock, which was a suggestion from her boyfriend, Dr. Aphra, misandrist, Asian, racist, angry, bitch, and the writer, misandrist, racist, whitey hater. And of course, Story Group, Matt Martin saying that it didn't matter, canon doesn't matter, just recently, and here she is again, here's Kennedy. And of course, the firing of Gina Carano. It was confusing and hypocritical. So let's talk about this. What is she responsible for? Well, when TFA came out, it made $2.3 billion. And it really just banked out on, I think, fan service, a lot of really bad fan service. When you slice and dice that movie, you realize that it was nothing more than a very, very bad retelling of A New Hope. The writers, it was apathetic. It destroyed all three OT characters, or was basically the start of that. Totally ruined Han Solo. Any of you Luke Skywalker fans ought to realize that should have been your clue, okay? That should have been your fucking clue, all right? And you can't just blame the executives. Kennedy never stuck up for Lucas's vision. And it's obvious by the reception the movie's got. That movie, then TFA, TLJ came out, and she basically let Rian Johnson run amok. She basically let him do whatever he wanted. And the backlash shocked the executives. So whose fault was it? Was it their fault for letting her do whatever she wanted? Yeah. Was it her fault for not reining in Rian Johnson? Yeah. But I'm going to tell you something. After watching a lot of this stuff and hearing about what went on, I'm going to say this. Kathy Kennedy, despite what that Reddit leaker said, every movie she got everything she wanted. Let's go to The Rise of Skywalker. They have a rough cut of it. JJ presents it. Kennedy, not the executives, Kennedy orders 40% reshoots, including that fucking kiss, so they could appease the fucking Raylos. Of course, you know, Kyle Ron, Daddy Butcher, emo douchebag dies. Ugly son of a bitch. But still, she got what she wanted. And, you know, when I look at things that I've heard, things that I've seen, seeing people that I don't really think were on the same page with her, getting thrown under the bus for the failures of the sequel trilogy and Solo, that were executives at Disney, I find it very interesting. Because let me put it this way, and then let you guys go. If Kennedy, if they had been watching what she was doing after she fired Gareth Edwards, they should have put a curb bit in her mouth and slowed her roll. After she hired Lord and Miller for whatever mysterious reason, I don't get it. I don't care if they were young. They were definitely not the correct directors for a Han Solo origin story film. That should have been a signal that she doesn't know what the fuck she's doing. Okay? Now, You can talk about her resume. But again, if I tell you the only time she was ever really successful was with her husband, Clint Eastwood, George Lucas, Steven Spielberg, John Milius, Robert Zemeckis, Martin Scorsese, okay? They were the ones that did all this stuff. She has no idea about what being creative is. Absolutely no idea. Look at the projects that are, look to be her ideas happening or so-called in development. We've got Rogue Squadron and Patty Jenkins and her pear-shaped ass doing a fan dance so it doesn't get canceled, and I'm pretty sure it's going to be. We've got The Acolyte, and weirdly, that was announced despite the fact that I'm pretty sure that she was told not to do it. And, you know, Harvey Weinstein's former assistant, which is weird that she would hire that person. That won't be made. And Lando. I don't see a real fan desire to have a Lando Calrissian origin story because of what they did to him in Solo. And that was her fault too. And when you look at the story group and what they did, you have to understand they were allowed to do it. This is my opinion, and then I will let you go. They were allowed to do whatever they wanted because she didn't care. She wasn't interested in the franchise. She had no fucks given on the franchise, okay? She doesn't like Star Wars. If she had cared, none of this stuff would have happened. If she was a fan, a real fan, none of this stuff would have happened, okay? J.J. Abrams never would have been hired. Okay, she would have found a competent director that understands what's at stake and would have kept him around for all three movies. You know, but here we are. So she has to share a lot of the blame. I'm not saying she should have all of it because Bob Iger should have been sitting on her chest screaming at her for the last 8 years. And it caught up to him in 2018 when Solo lost $250 million. Why? Because, again, and I'm going to remind everybody, Robert Mayer Burnett too, that she didn't see the dailies until the movie was 80% done. She ignored Larry Kasdan. Now, Larry Kasdan said, I'm never working with Disney again. But was it really Disney? This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.